Hi everyone, how are you all? I hope you are fine. And me, yes, I am fine too. Dear learners and honorable viewers, you are most welcome to my English class. I am Muhammad Rafiqul Islam, assistant teacher English at Meshrai Girls High School, Meshrai, Chattogram. Today our subject, English for today, this is for class 10. At first, I want to express best wishes to you all on the occasion of Holy Ramadan, Ramadan Kareem. You know, in this month, the Muslim community here in Bangladesh and across the world first during the day and perform Taraweeh prayer at night. At the end of the month, the Muslim community celebrate a big day, a big festival. Can you tell me what is the name of that festival? I think you know, and that is Eid festival, Eid al-Fitr. Now, I am going to show a video footage about this. Look at the screen. Watch the video. Watch the video very carefully and try to remember and guess. When do you see this type of huge gathering? And try to guess what's happening here. And later we'll discuss this scene. Okay, dear students, let's talk about this scene. What happened here? A terrible situation has been created here. We see in the video footage, hundreds of people, hundreds of thousands of people are gathering in different places. Lost terminal, bus stop, highways, rail stations, all the places become, overcrowded. They are taking high risk. Any types of occurrence may happen there. This time, my question is, why do these people take such high risk? Can you realize? I have realized. And I say, this is only for a kind of feelings. That is full of heart, full of love, full of affection, and full of blood. Students, we can define this is roots. So, this time, can you say what is the lesson of today's class? I am sure you can guess. And our lesson, my roots, okay? Write down our lesson title. My roots. Okay, before going to discuss this lesson, I'm taking you to again on the screen. So look at students, open your book at page 151. Unit 12, at the page, Unit 12, lesson, unit title roots. You see a picture of a tree. Learning outcomes. I'd like to read these outcomes. After we have studied the unit, we'll be able to participate in conversations and debates, exchange personal information, narrate incidents and events in a logical sequence, present own ideas, give and ask for information, write letters to newspapers, lodge complaint, and finally present information in a chart. After completing the whole unit, students, you can do all of this. Okay, now again, I'm taking to you to our boot. Okay. This time, open your book at 152. Students, I have selected 5 words for you, and I'm writing the word on the board, and you try to guess or remember the meaning of the word. Number 1, festival means, can you guess? Yes, celebration. Okay. Number 2, you can repeat after me, or you can read with me. The students, you can follow. Number 2, hazard. What's the meaning of the word? Hazard, risk. Yes. Okay. What comes next? This time, a word, a bit difficult for you, but try to guess. Invisible. Okay, invisible means that can't be seen. It's impossible to see. Can you guess? You know, this is unseen. Okay, now number 4. Bond. Bond means what? Bond means connection. Okay, finally, last word, hit. This is very common word. You know many meanings of this word, head, headmaster, head of part of body, but fully different meaning here. Head means going ahead, advance, proceed. Okay, right here, advance. Okay, write down the meaning of this word. And now, let's make some sentences with this word. Can you? Yes. The students, with the first word, festival, I can make like this. We celebrate Eid festival every day. Hazard. Smoking in a public places may cause health hazard. The third word, invisible. Invisible, you know, unseen, a pandemic disease, coronavirus is invisible to your naked eye, but it can be seen in a microscope, okay? Another word, bond. I can make a sentence with this word like this. We should have a strong bond between us and our relatives. Okay? But finally, you have to do this. Head. Okay, I can say our head, homegoers people are heading to their native village. Okay, dear students, now we're going to our text.
Okay.
Dear students, this time turn to page 152 in your book. You see Lesson 1, My Rules. Section A, I'm skipping here and move on section B. There is a text, scene comprehension. From this text, from this scene comprehension, 7 MCQ will be set in your exam. So this is very important to understand clearly the text. Okay, now I'd like to translate this text English to English, but I hope you will pay 100% your attention. Okay, you need 100% attention. You can repeat after me, or you can read with me, or you can follow, but try to realize, understand the meaning of the sentence. So let's go. Eid is the main religious festival of the Muslims in Bangladesh. You know, the Muslims community have many festivals, but it is their main principle, religious festival. It means happiness. It is an Arabic word. It means happiness. Everyone wants to share this happiness with near and dear ones. Yeah, near and dear ones means every kith and kin. Okay? So, most of the people who are living outside their homes for different reasons have a strong desire to get back home during the day Eid vacation. The students, we see a strong wish, a strong desire. We see, you know, many people stay or live outside their home for different reasons. Can you tell me some reasons? Oh, I can say the reasons of business, education, or job, for many more purposes or intention. So these people, but these people have a strong wish, desire to get back, return home during the Eid vacation. As a result, there is a madrash, crazy haste or crazy hurry to board. To board means to get on buses, trains or launches that we discussed a few minutes ago in the video footage for going home. This often causes transport accidents, means road accidents that take away, kill many lives. However, this cannot stop people from going home to meet their family, in-laws, or friends. That means all in spite of having all sorts of hazards, people must go and meet their family and friends. A text writer says, what makes people rush for their homes in spite of serious hazards, serious risk, danger? This is nothing but people's desire to return to their roots. That means only for the roots these people are taking risk. Do human beings put through a question, do human beings have roots like the trees? Do human beings have like the trees? Very strange question. Look here. Here is a picture. What is this? Can you tell me? All these are roots. And all these are roots. These roots grow underground, absorb water and minerals, and send it to the rest part of the tree. But, dear learners, do we have any roots with our legs? The answer is yes, but unlike the roots of the trees, they are invisible. Unlike the trees, that means we have also roots, but that is not similar to the those of tree, and that is invisible. They lie in our minds, they exist in our minds. It's these roots that make a bond between us and family. Turn to page 153. And moving on, members, us and laws, us and friends, neighbors, or even between us and the land where we were born and grew up. In that sense, in that context, our families, our land of birth, relatives, our culture, traditions, our surroundings, our roots. All these are our roots. Got the point? What is roots? And wherever we stay, we feel the power of our roots, energy of our roots, strength of our roots. It's our roots that develop our identity, making us what we are. When we lose that bond, we become rootless, baseless. When we mislay that bond, we become rootless. Human beings who do not have any roots are a non-entity. Do you know what's non-entity? Nobody. Non-entity means nobody. A person who has no any influence or any importance in a society. In other words, they do not have an identity. They don't know where they are from and or where they are heading to. This often makes them feel empty and lost. That means they feel high frustration. Okay, the students, this time I think I understand better the text now. And now move on to section C. Yes. Read the text in speech bubbles, make questions based on the bubbles, and then compare them in pairs. There are four speech bubbles. You are asked to make questions. Look here, Eid is the main religious festival of the Muslim in Bangladesh. To make question here, you just use here what instead of Eid. In the Eid, the position of Eid, just write here what, and then if you ask the question with this word, you can get again the information Eid. Eid is the, what is the main religious festival of the Muslims in Bangladesh? The next speech bubble of Eid means happiness, and if we remove happiness, we have to make question with the word what. If we ask with what, we can get back again this word. So put here what, then as this is in present simple tense, so and third person singular, use here does. What does it means? No s, and put here question mark. Third speech bubble, in that sense, our families, our land of birth, relatives, our culture, traditions, our surroundings are our roots. Just put here, instead of E, from in to surroundings, what? What are our roots? Okay? The last one is our roots that develop our identity, making us what we are. The students, this is very simple. That means, what do our roots do to us? Okay, got the point? Now I'm taking you to next section. Excellent section. Dear students, open your book at page 154. And this time, before that, I am going to say section D. Fill in the grid with appropriate information from the text above. There are two columns. In first column, you will write here 5 points that makes our roots, and write here again 5 points about the problems of rootless person. Now, this time, again, I'm taking you to the board. Okay?
Okay,
take out your exercise book and write down the points that are right here. Don't miss it. Number one, this time I will make first column that makes our roots. That makes our roots. Don't afraid of this question. You will find this information in your text, and just find and put here. Number one, that makes our, we can write here family members. Number one, family members. Do you write? Okay, members. Don't be lazy, write down quickly. Family members. Okay. Number two, we can write in-laws. And three, can you tell me? Friends. You have friends. Okay. This time I can write neighbors. All the information you will get in your text. Neighbors. No, you have to say this. The last thing you have to say. Get it? Or place of birth, birthplace. Okay, write down all these points. The students, this time I have written here that makes our rules. Now, after this, I write here the problems of the rootless person. Okay? I think we have written the problems of rootless person. The problems of rootless person. Okay, that means what type of problems does a rootless person face? Number one, lack of social or family ties. Lack of social or family ties. Number two, try to write yourself identity crisis. Identity crisis. Okay, and number three, unknown destinations. Unknown destination. Okay, and number four, non-entity. Okay, and the final you can write feeling of emptiness and loss. Feeling of, can you see clearly? Feeling of emptiness. Emptiness. Emptiness and loss. Okay? Write down all these points and practice at your home. Okay, the students, this time, we'll again moving on. Section E.
Okay.
Look at the screen. There are more two sections, a lot of sections in this lesson. Students, in the next classes, I will show you how to solve these sections. Now, this time, a surprising exercise for you. Look here. This is a question from Bogura Cantonment Public School and College, Bogura, Test Examination 2019, English Paper 1. I'm showing you a question, so you can be perfect by doing these types of exercise. Okay, let's start. Number one, choose the best answer from the alternatives. A. What does the phrase Madrash refer to in the passage? Okay. Number one, a violent forward motion, a sudden feeling of intense pleasure, a wild hurry to go somewhere or to obtain something, a burst of activity or productivity or speed. The students try to guess which answer is best. Perhaps a sudden feeling. Yes. The answer should be three. A wild hurry to go somewhere or to obtain something. I know you can. B. And wherever we stay, we feel the power of our roots. What is the word root mean here? The source of something, the lower part of something, the essential core, a close relationship with our birthplace. You can say a close relationship with our birthplace. Okay, another question. See which of the following best describes the people having no roots. and try to answer their question before me, before I say they are great patriots. They have no identity, they are irresponsible, they have no relatives. What? Perhaps they have no identity. Okay, it means you know directly I am going to number 4, happiness. Okay, number E, what is the main theme of the passage? The celebration of Eid in Bangladesh. Rootless people, hazards that you face when you rush to your homes. No. Number 4 is the best answer. Roots that make a bond between us and our family, in-laws or friends. Okay, rest 2. F. Which of the following cannot stop people to meet their family during Eid? Serious hazards. Financial problem. Shortage of transport. Ceaseless man. I think serious hazards. Okay. Last one, G. During Eid vacation, transport accident is very rare, little, common, minor. And the correct answer is common. Okay, the students, this time I'm going to take an assessment from you and take part in this assessment and try to solve this question. Okay, the word madrash in the text means a few seconds later I will tell you the answer of this question. Moving very quickly, general movement, moving aimlessly, moving slowly. The pull of roots makes people homesick, home maniac, home lover, home stricken. The causes of our home sickness lie in our behavior, hearts, activities, attitudes. And number 4, our roots are a combination of our kith and kin, total environment of birthplace, both A and B, D, none of them. Okay, when we lose our bonds, we become rootless, fruitless, valueless, and meaningless. Now check your answers. Okay, this time I'm giving a little homework. But this don't be afraid of this. This search, make a classroom survey and present in a chart the types of roots your classmates have. The source English for today, your book, class 9 and 10, section MP, page 154. A lot of lessons, a lot of things, the students you have learned. So this time, I want to finish this class. And at the same time, I want to give you information. In my next classes, I will give you a clear roadmap of our syllabus. How can we complete? How can we finish our whole syllabus before exam? So the students, never forget to do this homework and try to practice and. Stay at home, be safe. Thank you very much. Allah.